Hey everybody, it's your girl Bunny. It's the Netflix original series, Jim Henson's The Dark Crystal: Age of Resistance, Season 1, Episode 6, by Gelfling Hand. That's coming up next. It's Bunny. So we have the Skeksis. They have taken back Deet, Princess Breya, and Celadon. They have captured them as traitors via Princess Celadon's permission. She has said they're traitors. You can have them, do what you will at May, because they are traitors against the Skeksis. So they're on their way, taking them back to the Skeksis castle. And remember, we still have Rayon, Naya, and we still have those soldiers in the forest from where they had been dream fasting. They're still in the forest, and they see this chariot in which they have been taken captive. Meanwhile, back at Hara, we have the stone creature who senses that Princess Breya is in danger, and he goes out of the castle in search of the chariot and in search of everybody else who has been taken captive. The stone creature is able to catch up with the chariot. They have a quick battle in trying to fight each other, and gladly the stone creature is able to retrieve everyone from this chariot. Unfortunately, the Skeksis get away. We have Celadon. She is at the palace, and she has declared herself All Madra. And she doesn't even do the traditional ceremony in making sure that her mother has the ceremony according to their clan. She is so angry and ready to get over that. That just goes to show that she has that much anger, not only towards her mother, but her sister, Princess Breya, as well. She's over it. She doesn't want to go through with tradition and having the respectful ceremony, and she has declared herself All Madra. While the others have been freed of the chariot, you have all of them in the forest together. The stone creature, you have Rion, you have all of them together in the forest, and some soldiers that are there, they notice them in the forest, and they're kind of skeptical at first, but they want to get closer to see what's going on. And they share with the soldiers that you must dream fast with us so you can start to spread the truth. You can see it in your own vision from our thoughts that what has been going on and the rumors that have been going on about me killing the girlfriend, about the Skeksis being oh so wonderful and they're not. You get to finally see the truth. So they dream fast with these soldiers, and they say that you must spread the word to the other Gelfling. You must spread this throughout, not just Stone in the Wood, but everywhere. And yes, that new information starts to spread very quickly. The truth finally starts to spread to everyone. So you have all of those characters, Deet, Hup, Princess Breya, Rion, Naya, you have all of them in the forest. And throughout their journey, they realize that one of the places that they have to go to is, I think it's called Desert of the Sea. It's actually the Crystal Desert. And they find out that they have to go here in order to find out more truth to their journey, symbols, how they can get things back in order. But they learn that the sand there is very dangerous, and it constantly shifts, and it has the equivalence of walking on water, which is pretty impossible. So they need to collectively think, what are we gonna do when we get to the Crystal Desert? We're introduced by a new character named Archer. So Olga goes to see Archer and tells him, I had a vision that you must go to the Crystal Desert and defeat the hunter. As everyone takes a breather to rest and sit thinking about how they're gonna cross the Crystal Desert, Princess Breya says, I just really need to think about my mother. And she sits down to think about her mother, and she realizes that wow, I've never really had a relationship with my mother because it's constantly been about politics. I've never had a chance to sit down with her and talk with her in ways that I wish that I could. It was always about things that were going on in her job, and it was always things that had to do with being a princess. And I just wish that I could go back and spend more time with my mother and talk with her. Well, since it's been an unfortunate situation, she realizes that since she can't attend the ceremony for her mother, that she wants to sing for her mother and think about her. And they all join in to say positive words, and they sing together a very nice song to remember Almadra. Princess Celadon, she burns her mother, and with their clan, that's not of tradition, but she does it out of anger and sadness, and she can't help but to sit there and cry about it. But she's so angry, she's not thinking about how disrespectful it is, that she's not thinking about her mother. She's so focused on what is respectable to the Skeksis, she didn't even think about, you witness the Skeksis murder her. So if they're willing to murder her, she had no inclination, and she's not thinking clearly about, clearly they can hurt somebody else or murder somebody else. But Celadon is so angry, she's seeing past all of that. Back at the Skeksis castle, we see in their dungeons and chambers all of these soldiers that have been collected and have perished because the scientist has captured all of their essence, and they are slowly dying. And there are a lot of them that are still in captivity in cells, bunched up in a lot of them bunched up in one cell at a time. So only one was able to escape in this first batch of Gelfling that they have, but clearly they're gonna keep going until they get all of the Gelfling that they need in order to catch all of the essence. We have Madra Farah from Stone in the Wood, and she comes to Hara to see Celadon and to give her comfort that her mother has passed away. And she's telling her, we've got to revenge your mother's death, and we're surrounded by people that are just being very deceptive. And as soon as she's speaking, Celadon cuts her off and says, well, no, they were traitors. And Madra Farah says, well, what a lot of people have been dream fasting says something completely different. So you're not understanding the truth. The Skeksis are not for us. The Skeksis have caused a lot of danger, and they're bringing darkness to the crystal, and it's infecting everything within Thra. So you are very much mistaken. Chamberlain returns to the Skeksis castle to see that the rest of the Skeksis and some of the mystics are in pure glutton of essence. They are not trying to ration any of the essence, knowing how difficult it is to get the Gelfling. They have a spread of a table with food, and they're drinking all of the essence and wasting it and throwing it and just saying, I feel great. This is wonderful. I've never felt so eternal ever. And they're drinking, and they're just drinking all of the essence, and Chamberlain can't believe how out of control it's gotten. All of the different mantras of the seven clans come to Celadon to comfort her and to crown her as the new Almadra of Hara. But Madra Farah, she's very reluctant, and she's just not for it. And when they turn in their votes, they notice that they are two votes short. So we have Madras that don't agree with the vote either, that she should take her mother's place just yet, because things seem a little bit fishy. So Madra Farah tells Celadon, I challenge you to fight for that position because I don't think you deserve it. And one of the Madras tells Farah, be careful, because Celadon may seem sweet and kind, but she's very clever, especially when it comes to fighting. So you might want to rethink that. The rest of the group, they finally arrive to the Crystal Desert, and they realize that there's no way that we can get across. It looks like it's miles and miles of sand, and we're just going to have to sit here and maybe think of something. And then all of a sudden, they see a creature fly in, and it is the Sand Master who has found them. And he says, I heard your songs, and I felt your positive energy across the desert. And I can make a guess that you will want me to escort you across the desert and where you're trying to go. Now, I can get you only so far, but I do offer my services and I do want to help you. And they're all very happy that the Sandmaster has been able to hear their song and feel their positive energies. So they are more than happy to have the Sandmaster help them on as far as he can get them across the Crystal Desert. Farah is under the impression that they're about to have this challenge, and she is ready to have this challenge with Celadon. And she's waiting and waiting for Celadon, I guess, to get in this challenge or dress appropriately for the challenge. And when Celadon walks out, she reminds you of Queen Cersei when she put on the all black. And she came out with her new do, and she says, "There is no reason for me to challenge you, Madra Farah, because I am all Madra." And she looks like she has turned to the dark side, and she lets them know, the Skeksis give me this power. The Skeksis are for me. The Skeksis let me know that I am the loyal one, so there's no reason to fight. And all of the other Madras, they look around, and it's like they have to agree, because if they disagree with this one, they may have the Skeksis coming after them. So that was pretty much the cliff notes of that episode. We still have a lot to go. We still have 7, 8, and 9, and 10, which have a lot of detail. So I hope these recaps have helped you, and I hope that you're getting the information that you need very quick and very straight to the point. There were other things that happened, but of course, I hit the bullet points on the things that mattered the most. Let me know what you think. Subscribe, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any posts, and also follow me on Instagram, same profile name, officialbun_E. I see you for episode 7. Bye.